Insofar as you can, take us inside that room. What was said? What was accomplished?
Well, the president, as he stated when he was elected, he's trying to find ways to reduce barriers for people and for business to grow. And so inside the room, a bunch of governors and some of his staff, we talked about different regulations, different areas that we could take a look at, and then talk amongst each other to see how we can reduce barriers. For example, in Alaska, we have a very large military population. We have a number of military bases. You get folks transferring in. You may have spouses, for example, that are nurses or have other professional degrees. Sometimes it's difficult to bring that licensure into a state such as Alaska. Without it taking a lot of time to get that person prepared to actually get a license from Alaska. So we're having the discussions with other states, with the president, how we can have a reciprocal agreement with a lot of states so that when those folks come right in, they can go right to work and we get that expertise that we need.
So you make a great point here, Governor. We've heard from other people, labor economists, the percentage of workers, regular workers who are subject to state and local regulation has grown and grown and grown and grown, and it sometimes can impede labor markets as a practical matter. Is that your experience in Alaska, and what can you do, or what have you done for that matter, to try to address that problem?
Yeah, again, for us, the bases highlight this with the military spouses. And so with a tight labor market, tightening labor market in the lower 48, as we call the rest of the United States, it becomes more difficult to get some of these professionals. So this would be very helpful for Alaska once we do this. And so we're looking at that regulation as well as probably 200 others that we have on the books in Alaska to see how we can modify or eliminate those regulations to improve the business climate, the professional licensure climate, just being able to make it easier for people to work and for businesses to do business in Alaska.
Do you need the legislature to help you? Because there have been times in the past over the budget you've had some problems with the legislature. You had to make some tough decisions up there. Does the legislature with you on this deregulation?
We're having that discussion, and we think the legislature is going to be on with us on a lot of these regulations. Again, we want to make sure that the regulations that are kept in place are there to protect people, but not impede people or impede business. And that's what we're looking at.
Where are you on the budget? Because we talked to you last year, and it was really pretty rough. There was even a recall effort that didn't go anywhere, but there was a recall effort. Where are you on this year's budget? Is it easier this year than last year?
Well, so last year we reduced the budget by about $650 million. We had a $1.6 billion deficit. We closed that by about a third, a little over 40%. This year we went in with a flat budget because we actually, and this is another issue that we're talking about in Alaska, we have statutory formula programs that consistently increase the cost within the budget. In other words, push against the ceiling in the budget. So we're going to talk with the legislature about rolling back potentially some of those statutory programs so that we can keep a flatline budget, and then our administration, our different departments are looking at ways to more efficiently reduce the budget surgically without having to cut large chunks of the budget off.
Where are you with the university system? Because that was quite controversial last year, because one of the things you really had to cut.
Right. Well, at the end, we came up with a three-year agreement with the university system that we'd have a step-down process in terms of reducing the budget. We signed an agreement. Things are going well there, so things are looking pretty good for the university in terms of the budget on our side as well. So
let's talk also about trade, because Alaska, it's important for Alaska trade, both inbound and outbound.
Right.
We now have a USMCA that looks like they're going to make it through sometime in the new year.
Right.
We also have, it looks like, a U.S.-China trade deal. What does that mean for Alaska?
So we have trade with Canada, for example, our eastern neighbor, of about $700 million, almost $800 million per year. So what occurs in USMCA is going to help Alaska with that trade in terms of intellectual property, potentially energy, machinery, et cetera. We really trade with Asia, though. Our trade with Asia is in the billions. And so we are the furthest western state in the United States. We're really a Pacific Rim state, Alaska is. We're also on the Arctic Ocean as well. So our closest neighbor is Russia, just a few miles away. But when we get this trade issue settled with China, I think it's going to be very helpful for Alaska because we deal with a lot of fish, timber issues with China as well as Japan and Korea.
How much of that Asian export is going to China specifically? Because you're reasonably close to China.
About 1.3 billion, more than Japan. It's our biggest trading partner.
And have you had issues with access to markets, or are the things that you're exporting pretty open from China's side?
I think they're pretty open, but we just have to be careful that in this agreement, in the trade agreement, that we also protect our fisheries from a potential high seas fishery that intercept our fish. So we're working through that with our federal delegation. They're working with Representative Lighthizer and others that are doing the negotiations, but we're keeping an eye on this and
When it comes to fisheries, what are the biggest challenges for you? Japan historically has been a big fishing nation, for example.
Yes.
Russia as well. What are the biggest challenges for you up in Alaska
in
terms
always,
of the fish?
Right. For example, you have the Russians that are just across from us, Bering Sea, and we just want to make sure that everyone's being held to the same standard when we're trading so that one does not get an unfair advantage. We believe that Alaska's product, our fresh-caught fish, is the best in the world. So if we have trade agreements that level the playing field, we believe that we can compete and actually do pretty well in this environment.
As you look at growth potential for Alaska, what's the number one target for you? What's the biggest opportunity?
Well, that's interesting you ask that, because we've always been known as a resource state, and we'll continue to capitalize on our resources, oil, gas, hopefully timber. We'll stand up a robust timber industry, I hope, in the near future, as well as more fishing. But it's our location, I think, that's going to bode well for Alaska. We're about 9 hours by air to any industrialized place in the northern hemisphere. We also have the second busiest cargo airport in the entire country and the fifth busiest cargo airport in the entire world, and that's growing rapidly. We have about $500 to $700 million of new investment in that airport to handle cargo. Also, we're in conversation with individuals in Alberta to potentially connect a rail link with Alaska to Alberta and the lower 48 so they can transport their products through Alaska. So transportation, location, I think, are going to be big for Alaska in the next several years.
How important are U.S. military bases to you up in Alaska? Because we just have a new appropriations bill coming through, and there's a lot more money for the military.
Yeah, we have several military bases in Alaska. We have an intercept missile site at Delta Greeley, Fort Delta Greeley. Fort Wainwright. Wainwright is a big Army base up in Fairbanks. Eielson Air Force Base, J-Bear, Joint Base Elmendorf-Richardson. So we have a number of bases in Alaska. We have a large Coast Guard presence. It's very important because, again, our nearest neighbor is Russia, just a few miles away, and we are a Pacific Rim state. Okay.